Texas Tornado at Wonderland in Amarillo, Texas, is one of the most bizarre looping roller coasters in existence. Not many roller coaster enthusiasts make it out to Wonderland due to its location, but I always had my eye on this quirky park and its intriguing star attraction in Texas Tornado. Earlier this year, I squeezed this park into a road trip and finally got to experience Texas Tornado, and it rode unlike any other looping coaster I've ever ridden. Before I get into Texas Tornado, I want to set the stage. In the 1960s and 1970s, aerodynamics had a monopoly in the log flume market at US theme parks. Realizing the popularity of this attraction, the owners of Wonderland wanted their very own log flume. I promise this relates back to Texas Tornado. Hopkins Rides was founded in 1962 as a company that installed ski lifts. Over time, they started adding sky rides at amusement parks, and one of these sky rides can be found at Wonderland. So because of their forged relationship with Hopkins, the owners of Wonderland challenged Hopkins to develop a lower-cost log flume, and in 1980, they delivered the Big Splash log flume. And the log flume is arguably the attraction Hopkins became most well-known for. Flash forward to the mid-1980s, ever since aerodynamics had developed the first modern inverting coaster, amusement parks were in an arms race to get their very own looping coaster. And at the time, aerodynamics and Schwarzkopf were at the peak for steel looping coasters. Wonderland wanted their very own looping coaster, but they didn't like the price tag from the industry giants. And I kid you not with this next part, Wonderland approached Hopkins at a cocktail party and asked Hopkins, a company who had never ever built a roller coaster, to design them a multi-looping steel roller coaster. So Hopkins sketched the attraction on a napkin, and that is exactly how you end up with something that looks like this. And as you may suspect from the bizarre appearance of the two loops, Texas Tornado had some design issues. Let's start with the first vertical loop. During initial testing, the pullout from the vertical loop was exerting too many G-forces. In addition, the train failed to complete the subsequent double up. To rectify the issue, Hopkins raised the exit of the first loop. This reduced the G-forces on the pullout and allowed the train to successfully complete the double up. But that revealed a second issue. The train could not complete the second vertical loop either. To remedy this, Hopkins went with the fastest and cheapest method possible. They lowered the track on that loop and fashioned steel supports extending from the pre-existing loop structure. While Texas Tornado can now complete its circuit, it is still a valiant risk. For that reason, Wonderland has two restrictions that can sometimes make Texas Tornado a bit difficult to ride. One, this ride cannot operate in high winds. Two, the coaster requires a minimum of 10 riders to be dispatched. The latter can be particularly troublesome if you visit Wonderland on a quiet weekday. Just for reference, I visited on a Saturday in the summer, and there were still points where I had to wait a few minutes on the platform for enough riders. I've heard stories about enthusiasts having to beg guests to get in line for Texas Tornado on weekdays. Texas Tornado is also unique for the trains that it uses. This coaster originally opened with a train from Hopkins, but was later replaced by a train from the Philadelphia Toboggan Company. This is the train that Texas Tornado utilizes today, and is the only steel coaster train ever built by PTC to my knowledge. And what matters most to me is the fact that these trains do not have over-the-shoulder restraints. Rather, they have lap bars, and this eliminates the chance of you getting headbanging. And that's certainly a good thing because the profiling of this coaster isn't perfect. But you probably realize that after seeing the MacGruber vertical loops. Once dispatched, you begin a slow climb up the 80-foot tall lift. To the right, you have a view of the highway. To the left, you have a view of the back half of Wonderland. And then you crest the drop and discover just what happens when a roller coaster is designed at a cocktail party on a napkin. I was optimistic the drop would provide airtime. It did not. And spoiler alert, there is absolutely no airtime anywhere in Texas Tornado. That is not what this coaster is about. What Texas Tornado excels at is positive G-forces. Whereas most drops have a sharp crest at the top and a gradual pullout, Hopkins reversed this on Texas Tornado. So you slowly roll over most drops, but the pullout is ridiculously sharp. As a result, you are slammed at the bottom with positive G-forces. After a bit of straight track at the base of the drop, you navigate the first vertical loop. While its circular nature looks reminiscent of a Schwarzkopf loop, this element feels quite a bit different. Whereas Schwarzkopf loops maintain those positive g-forces throughout the loop, Texas Tornado gives a bit of hang time atop the loop. Remember, this coaster is a valley risk, so it's not exactly a speed demon. But if you want your positive g-forces, don't worry, you get some positive g's exiting the loop. So I'm definitely curious just how intense those g-forces must have been before the exit of this loop was modified and raised. That's then followed by the double up the train barely crests. It's a pretty dull point in the layout if you ask me. But you then dive beneath the chute the chutes, and the pullout from this drop is incredibly tight. It's even tighter than the pullout at the base of the drops. As strong as the positive g's were at the base of the drop in first loop, the positive g's at the base of this turnaround were even more intense. That again had me wondering just how intense the g's at the base of the original loop must have been if they were stronger than this element, because I really can't think of many coasters with stronger positive g's. You then ascend this giant camelback and crest it very slowly. This is yet another hill with a super drawn out crest that's a bit boring. But like the first drop, the pullout is ridiculously tight, so this is yet another instance with some heavy positive g's at the bottom. You then rip through the second vertical loop. You take the apex of this loop with considerably more speed than the first loop, so there's no hang time. Instead, you get some light positive g's atop the loop combined with a little bit of shuffling. You then drop down to a tunnel, getting the ride's final instance of high positive g-forces. And this tunnel was sort of weird in that it was pitch black during the day, but at night, the park turned the tunnel's lights on. I just found that odd. When you re-emerge into the daylight, you pass over the River Rapids ride, which, fun fact, was the first River Rapids ride developed by, you guessed it, Hopkins. And then you hit the brake run, ending this bizarrely forceful coaster. Texas Tornado is far from a refined ride, but those imperfections are what make it stand out in my opinion. The pullouts from every single element feel way too tight, and as a result, they pummel you with positive g-forces. Some may find this uncomfortable, but I found Texas Tornado quite re-rideable because the coaster actually tracked pretty darn well outside of that shuffle I mentioned atop the second loop. So what would I rate Texas Tornado? I'd give it a 7.5 out of 10. I love the intense positive g-forces in Texas Tornado, but this coaster does not have the best pacing. As I alluded to in the review, Texas Tornado has some dead spots where it doesn't carry much speed through the layout. If the hills in Texas Tornado actually offered airtime, this would have been a near-perfect coaster and fixed the pacing issue together. But as it stands, Texas Tornado should be sought out by anyone who's a fan of heavy positive g-forces. Wonderland may be off the beaten path for most enthusiasts, but those unique ride sensations of Texas Tornado and the park's diverse ride collection make this worth visiting if you've been to all the other major parks in the United States. What are your thoughts about Texas Tornado? Are you a fan of coasters that focus on positive G's? I would love to hear your comments down below. Thank you for listening, and if you liked this video, I'd appreciate it if you gave it a like and subscribe for more roller coaster reviews and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster.